Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're going to look at the new color profiles on the Mavic Pro. Since the last video I did about best camera settings for the Mavic Pro, there's been a firmware update that actually removed one of the, what I thought was one of the best color profiles, Art. So with help from Brad Buskey, what we've done is a few tests to look at the new color profiles and see what works best for final color correction, final grading. This is for folks who are planning on doing a little bit of post work to their footage after they've shot it. As far as the Mavic Pro is concerned, I found some amazing results, I think. One of which is the D-Log profile, I think is out. I've shot on D-Log for the entire time that I've owned my Phantom 3 Pro, and it's worked really well, but I think this is a case where you've really got to work with the camera's strengths and work around the weaknesses. And D-Log on the Mavic Pro turns out to be just muddy. It's difficult to get decent results from the footage. So I think D-Log is pretty much, for me anyway, is not a real usable profile. It's just too flat and too muddy. But surprisingly, Cine-Like profile is the one that I'm recommending. Cine-Like is a little bit brighter, it's a little bit higher contrast, but it does tend to maintain details even in the highlights, which I was kind of afraid of because it looks very bright on screen. But there are details left in the Cine-Like profile that makes it kind of nice, and the overall tone of the image is pretty balanced, pretty, you know, straight down the middle. So Cine-Like, I think, is the best color profile settings for the Mavic Pro. And the only caveat to that is, on your sub settings for sharpness, contrast, and saturation, tweak all three of those down to -1. Again, the contrast kick down just a little bit helps maintain a little bit more dynamic range so the image isn't too hot or too dark. The sharpness taken down just a notch at -1 helps it from being a little bit too crispy looking. And saturation at -1 helps maintain your colors to where they're not too super saturated and you've still got something to work with in post. Now here's the amazing part. When I started looking at the new color profiles, the film color profiles, it's A through I. I had heard that these were more of a looks kind of thing, like an Instagram kind of thing, which I was disappointed in because I thought it's, you know, they're trying to turn the Mavic Pro into the selfie drone. I was wrong. Believe it or not, some of these film profiles are pretty nice. And when I say pretty nice, I mean every one of these profiles, make no mistake, they do have a grade applied to them. It is a color grade, but more so a color grade than a special effects filter, which is a big difference to me. You know, Instagram kind of stuff is more of a special effects filter, but these have a nice color grade to them, which I found really pleasing and subtle enough to where they were tastefully done. The film profiles that I really liked were A, G, H, and I. A has this wonderfully cinematic quality where the shadows are pushed toward the blue, but the mid-ranges and the highlights are pushed a little bit toward the reds and yellows. So it's got this really beautiful, very subtle, but definitely a beautiful color grade to it. The G color profile has a very soft yellow cast to it, like the white balance is leaning a little bit toward the yellows. It makes for a great color profile that has a little bit more of a warm and friendly look to it. I'm going to skip H and come back to that one, but the I color profile has a really wonderful soft quality where the shadows are more neutral, but the mids are brought up a little bit in the reds, and it gives us, again, this really nice cinematic quality that's tastefully done, not over the top, but it's a great effect if you don't want to do any kind of post-processing work with your footage. The H film color profile is one that I found really pleasing because it's a very neutral centered profile. It's a little saturated because it is a film look, you know, but it's a little bit more saturated. The white balance of H is pretty centered to my eyes, meaning that you've got good blues, good reds, good yellows, you know, the full color spectrum. So that's a great profile to shoot with. Again, if you're wanting something that's very straightforward, but with a little bit of look to it and a feel to it, I think that H works really well. So that's all I've got for now. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you're new, please subscribe. And if you don't mind, please give me a like. But other than that, I will talk to you guys very soon. You guys have a great day.